breed-specific legislation. As an example, we take out the evolution of breed-specific legislation in the Netherlands, which started at regeling agressieve dieren in Dutch, which means like a settlement for aggressive animals. And that law was there because they wanted to phase out pit bull terrier type of dogs. So what did this mean? There were troubles with some type of dogs, or at least there was a stigma of some kind of dogs because they came from fighting pedigree and could be used in dog fighting, which they didn't like, and also they had a tough dog radiance about them. And then they said, instead of that, no, these dogs are very dangerous. Of course, if people keep a dog as a status symbol and want it to be aggressive, you can get into trouble, but it can be with any dog. But instead of saying what I mentioned, there was a political driver. They said there were dogs that had a lot of incidents and they were very dangerous. So then they said they are aggressive animals and should be ruled out. What it meant in the Netherlands that you could not have American Pit Bull Terrier type of dogs because you needed to have a pedigree, otherwise that dog could be taken in and destroyed. And this went quite far, so not only dogs that were, for example, genetically American Pit Bull Terrier dogs, but also dogs that resembled that. And the American Pit Bull Terrier dog is not a kennel club registered type of dog in the Netherlands, as in many places. It's not FCE recognized, so to say. And in this case, for example, if you had a miniature pincher, which would not be a regeling agressieve dier type of dog, but was crossed with a, for example, a Bordeaux dog or a bulldog, and it looked like it looked like a football type of dog. It was ruled as a dangerous dog. So just on appearance alone, and not able to produce that you have a dog that's is a recognized show breed. That was enough to kill thousands of dogs. And also all the dogs that went into shelters, if they only looked a little bit like this, they had an incentive to destroy them and get their quotum. And it was a very poor situation, especially since it is known by someone who really knows the breed. Oi oi, the dogs of American Pit Bull Terrier type, or any canine gladiator for dog-to-dog interaction with human referees and handlers, should be very human-friendly. So it should not be a danger for humans. They can be a danger for other animals, especially dogs, of course, but this was not given as a reason. Another thing is that it was just on appearance. On appearance, for example, also if you had a dog Argentino without a pedigree, it would be an aggressive dog and therefore could be killed. So also Grazer Canario, a boxer crosses, and what have you. All types of dogs that are known to be very friendly, also among other type of dogs, the boxers in this case, not so much dogo Argentino or Grazer Canario. But if you look at the real incidences, there's sort of a lot of shepherd type of breeds, and also more of this band dog type of breeds, So that also included a lot of molosser, mastiff blood. A far more damaging effect because they are bigger and also were used quite often to guard premises instead of a canine gladiator, which is normally very human friendly, and these were excluded. So you can imagine what happened. And also a lot of fairy tales, such as that the Bible Terrier was not able to release its jaws, were just debunked and referred to that fairy tales. But this was a good time, it also helped a lot. Oi oi, it's stopping the racial profiling of these breeds. So that's part one. Then the second part. Now we have a new breed specific legislation, which is called high risk dogs. So hoog risico honden in Dutch. And they have made a list, and it includes, for example, other breeds than only a pit bull type of dogs. But still, all the pit bull type of dogs are also again on the list. Including bully pit bulls. Including Staffordshire Bull Terriers without pedigree. If you have a pedigree, you are exempt. If the parents have it, but if they don't, and then you are ready. Again, trying to show if you are a dog that is good at functioning. In the past, they already made a test called the MAG test, wachttest, maatschappelijk aanvaardbaar gedrag in Dutch, which means so much as socially acceptable behavior. They tested the dogs in all kinds of situations to see if they would show aggression towards humans, if they would be fearful. Able to attack other dogs, and now they are still, you have to pass those tests in order to be another high risk type of dog. So they want to make it more difficult to keep these types of dogs altogether. This time also Akita Inus, for example, are on there. Rottweiler was on there, then was off again, and then a little bit on again. It's a silly thing, and again this is even a little bit better because they don't only include pit bull type of dog, but a little bit more broad. But still, the dogs that are very dangerous and often use us also as an attack dog and trained and bred to do this, for example Malinois or German Shepherds or other Dutch Shepherds, are not included. These type of dogs are more tactical dogs. So funny thing.